The Wally Show podcast is our daily radio show heard live through the WayFM app each morning and hosted by Wally, Gavin, and me, Betty Rock. For more fun, be sure to connect with us at wayfm.com/Wally.
The Wally Show podcast is brought to you by Colorado Christian University Online, where you can earn a degree online just like Betty Rock. You can learn more at ccu.edu/Wally. The regular news can be a steady stream of negativity.
Mischievous and deceitful. Chicanerous and deplorable.
But we like to see the brighter side of things. It's news-ish on The Wally Show.
When Josie Flessler was only 3 years old, her aunt and uncle gave her the gift of 2 brand new baby ducks.
Oh, I have actually owned ducks before. Uh-huh. I saved them from like a side of a road situation.
Oh.
Peepers and Quackers. That's what I named them.
That's cute. Yeah,
you brought them home?
I did. I brought them home and then tried to keep them in the bathroom.
What?
Little known fact. Ducks poop a lot, and they destroyed my bathroom, and so I had to rehome them. But I did save them first, but I know the joy of owning a duck.
It was
pretty amazing.
And especially at 3 years old, Josie decided to call the two ducks Sophia and Ellie.
That's better than Peepers and Quackers.
The two ducks became the best of friends and did everything together. That is until 4 years later, the Flessler family noticed Ellie was missing.
No, why Ellie? Well,
that was weird.
That was weird, Gavin.
Unfortunately, Ellie had been taken by some other animal, and now Sophia.
Good news.
Sophia was all alone. With the Michigan winter months coming, Flesslers knew they needed to move quick and find Sophia another companion if she was going to be able to make it through winter. Yeah. So they decided to post a personal ad. It spelled out what had transpired recently on the property and how the family was in need of another duck. And it also said, quote, single female, loves long walks by the pond, bright orange feet. The post got a lot of attention from the locals, and the want ad was answered by another local Michigan family. So they had 2 ducks they couldn't keep anymore.
Oh, wow.
And they were willing to part with them for the sake of Sophia having friends again.
Oh, that's so neat.
So Josie now, at 7 years old, has named the 2 new additions Lucy and Goosey.
Nice.
And well they done. Say that they're doing really well. They're 3 new besties. They have found out that Goosey is male.
Oh, okay.
So there could be babies in the future.
No, there could be a love triangle. Like, this could be really bad. There could be so much drama.
Stop. I love everything about this story.
I know you do.
Precious.
Just to go back, though, Ellie's gone. Like, they never found
they
Ellie?
Did. They found some things that let them know she is trans.
Oh,
she's
sorry. I shouldn't have brought that up.
She's why not around anymore.
That was the wrong
What is wrong
angle.
With you? We were in such a good place.
I want everyone to envision 3 ducks walking to a pond as the sun sets, and it's a beautiful, beautiful scenario.
And okay? Gavin wants you to imagine one duck somewhere lost in the woods has been mauled. Thanks, Gavin.
I'm so sorry.
So there you go. Well, that's really nice. At least it ended well for 3 of the 4 ducks. Think about it. Going back to my ducks, I wish I had named them Soup and Quackers. I think that would have been better than Peepers and Quackers.
Well, hindsight's 20/20.
I got to go get some more ducks. Uplifting WayFM, this is The Wally Show. And I don't know if I've talked about this much on the show, but there's a movie called I Can Only Imagine. And it starred myself and Dennis Quaid.
You gave yourself top billing there.
Oh, I did that by accident. Sorry, I didn't realize I was doing. But it's the story of Bart Millard from Mercy Me and his life. But Dennis Quaid was his dad, and he was great in the movie. And I had a slightly smaller part than Dennis. Wasn't as big.
Slightly
smaller. It was very powerful.
There was a big span between what you did and what he did. He was like a main character where you had a 3-second appearance. Could say you were a background performer.
No, because I actually had lines. And if we were doing movie trivia and the question was, who had the last words in the movie I Can Only Imagine? Ding, 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 it would be me.
Oh, my word.
Yeah, so let's see Dennis Quaid do that. But anyway, I digress. I was at another screening for a movie called Ordinary Angels. And Dennis Quaid was there. And I'm like, oh my goodness, that's kind of crazy. He's like, here.
Hey, bud.
I know. I thought about, well, okay, here's where I mean, I kid around about all this stuff, but I am self-aware enough to go, I don't infringe on celebrities and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So he was even talking to the director, who is a friend of mine, and I just kind of walked by and I kind of tapped Andy on the shoulder and I'm like, hey, see you Thursday, because he's going to come in for an interview. And I didn't stop because Dennis was going on about how good the Ordinary Angels movie is to him. So I didn't, I'm self-aware enough. I don't want to stand there and then wait for the thing. And I, hey, Dennis, I was in the movie you were in. And then, you know, and you're like, it's just horrible. But I had wanted to get a picture for you and me, like to
for me,
to, yeah, to do a selfie of me to be like, look, it's me and Dennis hanging
I don't
out.
Want
yeah,
that.
I wanted to do that just to like be funny, you know. Uh-huh. And so I didn't. And so then he comes out.
He is in Dennis.
Dennis Quaid, yeah. And he married young, or is dating somebody very young. I thought it was somebody that worked for him.
No.
And my wife's like, that's his wife.
Yeah.
I'm like, Dennis. And so I was going to, like, my wife's like, do you want to get a picture with him? And I didn't want to be that person because no one else was doing photos there. Everyone, it's like, it was a room of industry
yeah.
people. And so you just don't do that.
It just looks unprofessional.
It really does. Yeah. And so, like, I really did, like, it was everything I could do to not just go, hey, can we do a quick selfie? Like, when people do that to me, I don't care. I'm not a big celebrity, but people ask me for selfies all the time. And so it's like it never bothers me. I think it's fun. But I'm on a different plane than he is. And so I didn't want to be that guy, but I missed the opportunity. I really wish I would have, because I could have put it with my I Can Only Imagine poster hanging in my office.
Oh, my word. I'm glad you didn't, because
thank you.
I'm honestly shocked that you were able to read the room
yeah.
and realize that that wasn't something you should do.
Yeah.
And you kept yourself from doing it. So I think you made the right call.
In retrospect, I think I did too. My wife was like, I don't think it's a big deal. I would have taken it for you. You know, I'm like, I think it's a big deal.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I did not. So that was my missed opportunity. And that's what I want to discuss right now with you. 855-33-WAY-FM. Now, it could be celebrity based. It was a missed opportunity. It could be professional. It could be personal. It could be family. Whatever it is. But what was that thing that you're like, man, I missed my opportunity and I kind of wish I had taken it? 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. We'll take yours now. What's a missed opportunity for you, Heather?
I was at a restaurant and working, and Morgan Freeman came in.
Ooh.
He was buying an airplane here in Wichita, Kansas, and I totally wanted to get a picture or signature, but because I was his waitress, my boss informed me that I had to be professional, and I couldn't ask for a picture or an autograph, so I didn't. And now, looking back on it, I really wish I did.
And also, we live in yeah. a world where if you don't have a photo of it, then it didn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is tough
right.
because now it's just your word saying Morgan Freeman walked in. I mean,
and Betty doesn't believe you, is
right.
what she's saying.
Heather, sure he did. Sure, sure he did.
I was totally upset because other people, like customers, were coming up there. And like, hey, you know, I'm like,
oh, yeah.
If they can do it, why can't I?
But I'm sure he was appreciative of the fact that you didn't. I think it was the
probably
right
so.
Call.
Yeah, yeah.
Big question. Did he tip well?
Well, the Cessna people paid for it.
Okay.
So I didn't get a big tip.
Oh, they're selling planes.
Come
do you know
on.
How much those yeah. planes are?
It was like maybe $6 or something like that. Oh, like, come on.
That's rude.
What's yours?
So years ago, I've got three wonderful kiddos, and I had an opportunity to make a really good paying job, you know, six-figure year salary, and I just really felt like I was like, do you really want to do that? And one of the things I've done throughout my life is just ask people older than I'm, like, hey, what's your biggest regret? And they've always said, not been able to have enough time with my family. And during my second interview, I told the interview panel, like, hey, you know what? I want to spend more time with my kids and my family, and I appreciate the opportunity, and I walked out. Now, I'm a middle school teacher now, so I would have appreciated that salary.
Oh, absolutely, but, man. Wow. You went the total opposite direction.
Yeah, right. So, but I tell you what, with three wonderful kids, I wouldn't have traded the time in the world. So.
Frank is allergic to money. That's why he went into teaching.
It's easy to let the fear of the unknown keep us from doing something that is good for us, but going back to school might not be quite what you think.
Yeah, one of my biggest fears going back to school was I'd have to watch a ton of online lectures, and I kind of have a problem staying awake during stuff like that, but it was so different than I had imagined, and way better.
Yeah, for sure. I thought I was going to have to take a bunch of tests, which I am not a fan of, but instead I was able to write papers, which for me was way better.
Plus, you have the flexibility to work in school around your work and life schedule. Another big fear I had is, what if I don't understand something? What do I do?
Yeah, CCU, they foster community with your classmates, and they are a great resource. And Colorado Christian University has very responsive online professors who are there to help you so you are never alone as an online student at CCU.
Learn more about how you can pursue your passion and find your calling with Colorado Christian University at ccu.edu. Colorado Christian University is a nonprofit impact partner committed to cultivating the mind without compromising the heart.
In a broken world, stories with humor, heart, or hope are a nice change of pace.
There are some things money can't buy.
It's News-ish on The Wally Show.
So by now we all know the term photobombing, but Gavin and Betty, have you ever heard the term scarf bombing?
Scarf bombing?
Yeah.
When people take your scarf?
No, it's actually the exact opposite of that.
Oh,
when someone gives you a scarf?
Yeah, it's this cool idea that started coming up about 10 years or so ago where people would leave scarves in an area for people that were cold, like for the homeless or people who needed to stay warm. And Betty, you'll love this because it involves an old person. Betty, if you don't know this, Betty loves old people.
She does.
She wants to work with them one day. And I'm talking about older people than me. this is like a starter kit for her for working with the elderly, working with me. So there's a 71-year-old lady who saw this on Facebook, and it became her passion. She even knits a bunch of these scarves herself to give to people. So she launched the Scarf Bombardiers. It's French. It's hard to...
Whoa.
Yeah, Bombardier.
Bombardier.
But it's spelled I-E-R-S at the end. It's confusing. But anyway, she launched this in 2015. Says, we collect scarves all year round, and we put them on flagpoles or places where people are, where they can just pick them up, and we put tags on them just to make sure that people know it's okay to take this.
Aww.
And so it's really cool. She's like, we put them at bus shelters and places where there's a lot of foot traffic and where they would go to good use. She said that she's made like 400 crocheted scarves each winter.
That's a lot.
Yeah, that is a lot.
That takes time.
Yeah, that's not using a nifty knitter either, that automated machine.
Oh, yeah.
She's doing it by hand with crochet hooks.
Yeah.
And at 71, good on her.
But I love that because it just goes to show that no matter your age, you can help people in your own specific way.
Well, that brings me to this point. She said, you know, we have different kind of people that volunteer. Some people can make scarves, but they're limited mobility. They can't go deliver them.
Yeah.
And then other people can't make them, but they can partner in it by delivering them. And mm-hmm. so she's like, it works for everybody. And I love that the whole sole goal of this is taking care of people. That's it. There's no profit in this. There's no nothing. Mm. It's just doing the right thing by people every year.
There are no strings attached.
Yes.
No pun intended.
Yes.
Hey.
Because there are strings attached. They're all attached. Nicely
done. You didn't have to explain it. That made it
I know. That made it. That, I felt like it was just, I felt the metaphor was just a smidge off.
No, it spoke for itself.
It did, but it spoke backwards. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and every week when Gavin is preparing for his TMI, focuses on like some of the music news from our Christian artists, he finds too much stuff. We can't contain it all in TMI. And you found something really cool from Danny Gokey, right?
Yeah, you might know him from his song Love God and Love People. And if you don't know much about Danny Gokey, he's got a history where he, you know, performed on American Idol, and that was kind of one of his big breaks, but it was a little bit later in his life, and he kind of posted this video while he was doing a Q&A after a concert about the idea of kind of having God's plan happen a little later than he expected and being encouraged by that.
I turned 29 when I was on American Idol. Got dropped by my record label. And then things didn't take off for me until I had my first number one single at 34. I'm 43 now. So according to the world, I'm used up. I'm old. Our world idolizes youth because for some reason, it's one thing that goes away. You would be surprised at how many people feel like they're used up after they're done with the Disney Channel or Nickelodeon and they feel like they're a lost cause. God doesn't work that way. He builds legacy. Trust God to open the doors that need to be opened and just give him your gift without reserve and watch what he can do.
The thing about about God is he sees everything, and we have such a limited scope, you know, of what we are privy to. And that can be really frustrating sometimes, too. And so this is kind of what I want to unpack with you. It's like, when did you realize that God's plan was bigger than yours, or, you know, you didn't see what he saw, but then how did it work out? Like Danny Gokey, I'm sure when he was on American Idol, thought, I'm going to win American Idol, then I'm going to do this, then I'm going to do this. He had it all mapped out, but then none of that happened. It didn't go any of the way that he thought it should go. But I would argue, well, it's gone the way God would want it to go, but I would argue that it's gone better for him in this instance because of what he's getting to do now versus being in the pop world. He's making a difference in people's lives daily.
And who knows, you sharing your story about how God's plan was bigger than what you had even planned could be something that someone needs to hear. It's a hopeful situation where it's like, okay, I'm not used up, like, like Gokey was saying.
Yeah, Christine Kane, we had her on a while ago, too, and she is a great speaker and author, and she was talking about how, you know, everyone thinks it's your youth where you're the most viable, but all these studies show that actually the older you get, the more, you know, experience you have and the more you have to say and do, and, you know, God's not done with you yet, you know?
Well, and I think in America, we're pretty much the only ones that really value youth, whereas in other countries, it's like people value getting older because you get all this wisdom. So it's kind of like America is the complete opposite.
All right, so let's do this. 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. What is that thing that you look back now and you see God had a bigger plan than maybe what you had envisioned? 855-33-WAY-FM. What is a time that you look back now and you see God's bigger plan and what it really was for you?
So when I was growing up, my mother was addicted to drugs, and my dad left when I was about 6 or 7 years old. So growing up, I never really had both parents there to guide me and be the parents that I needed. And now, and back then, I didn't see that as a good thing. But now me and my husband are youth pastors, and every one of our youth group members comes from a broken home. So I'm able to sit down with them and, you know, say, I know where you're coming from, and be more on their level with these situations. My husband came from a wonderful, you know, family with both parents, and I did not. So I'm able to speak to kids that he can't speak to. And so now I'm thankful that I came from that because I'm able to use it for our ministry.
Yeah, in God's economy, nothing is wasted. You know, that's the thing. Yeah. Like your story of hurt, pain, brokenness, while it wasn't good for you, it's good for somebody else because you can identify with them. That's Romans 8:28. That's the thing. For we know that all things work together for good, not for necessarily us in that moment, but for those who are called according to his purpose. Like your pain can be somebody else's gain. And that's a hard thing to realize or be okay with when you're in the middle of it. But sometimes when you get past it, you go, I see there was a purpose for this pain. Well, Hannah, I really appreciate you taking the time to share your story today. You might have given somebody a perspective who's in it right now and doesn't understand why. So thank you.
Well, thank you for letting me share my story.
So, Roy, what was a time that now looking back, you see God's plan was bigger than yours?
My plan for my life when I graduated college was I was going to be a manager of a hotel or restaurant and have a family by 27 years old and all of that. And God told me, nope. And I ended up not getting married until my mid-30s. And now for the past 13 years, I've been a stay-at-home dad.
Oh, really? That's kind of a change.
Yeah, it's a big change. But it's been so, so rewarding to be able to just stay at home, invest in my kids' lives, and be there for them, pick them up from school, drop them off. And
I'm curious, do your buddies give you a hard time about being a stay-at-home dad, or are they like, dude, if I could get my wife to make more money than me, I would stay home in a heartbeat?
I don't get a hard time at all. I get more of a congratulations, that's awesome.
Yeah. If my wife was like the breadwinner in the family, absolutely. I'd be like, I'd be a stay-at-home dad all day. You kidding me? This is great.
Yeah.
Well, dude, I appreciate you being on the show with us today. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Wally. Be well.
So what's yours?
Well, actually, 3 years ago today, my son made a choice to commit suicide.
Oh, no.
At 16.
Oh, no.
And we thought things were fine. He was, you know, he's a typical teenager and that kind of thing. But there was so much more going on inside of him that we didn't know, and he hadn't confided to a bunch of people, and he reached a point, you know, he made a choice. And I wish he would have made a better choice, asked for help, but he didn't. And we are healing from that as best we can. But we've got so many stories out about how much he was helping others around him that we didn't know he was doing, that we wanted to carry that on. And so we started a nonprofit that grants a scholarship to a graduating high school senior. And also we go around and we talk at different events to encourage people to make a better choice.
I love how you guys found the other stuff that he did, you know, and you didn't want his legacy to be his bad moment, you know, because unfortunately that's what it was. It was a bad moment that was life ending, you know, but it wasn't what necessarily, had he made a different choice, would have defined his life.
We're also really, really proud of the fact that because of the work that we've done and the people that we've talked to, 45 people for sure, who have made another choice.
Boy, and that's 45 lives that now are altered because you chose to take your worst moment and use it for good. And that's what God does with us, you know, and I love that you have that perspective now. Even though it wasn't good for you and it hurt for you, you chose to make it redemptive for somebody else, and that's beautiful.
Absolutely.
Christy, I really appreciate you taking the time and sharing your story. I know it's not easy to keep reliving it probably, but thank you, because you never know again how your son's story today might have made a difference.
Absolutely. Thank you guys for what you do.
He's kind of smart.
Guys have underestimated me my entire life.
Sorry, read that wrong. He's kind and smart. It's News-ish with Gavin.
When it comes to the world of dating, I personally have been out of it for nearly a decade now. And
is it really? You've been with your wife for that long?
We dated for a little while and been married for 5 years. So, I mean, I personally, when I look at the world of dating now, though, it feels like it's changed a ton in the last 10 years. I don't know if that's, you know, technology, online dating, but it does seem kind of like a scary world to me. And I found
there's
this
part of me that would like to try it again.
Don't
wait. That sounds really bad.
Explain yourself.
Well, no, I'm gonna have to explain myself because I have a lovely wife of 31 years. But like you see, like I hear all of the horror stories like of Betty from online dating and stuff. And you're like, there's part, because I like to solve problems. And there's part of me that's like, okay, could I exist in that world? Mm. Could I make it? And I don't know that I could. You know, like, do I still have
that's
game?
That's horrible.
I don't.
No,
yeah.
You don't. You never had it. So
okay,
how
thanks.
How can you get what you never had?
Okay,
you know?
Fair enough.
Well, Betty, since you've had like the tougher experience when it comes to the world of online dating, I found this list of, they say, like the pettiest red flags out there that people have when it comes to.
I get that. We all have our things where it's like, if a potential date has that, you're like, I know it sounds ridiculous, but that's a no for me.
The guy that you didn't go out with because he had an extra thumb, I thought was a little shallow.
No, that's fair.
Yeah, no, that's shallow.
Two thumbs up.
Three thumbs up.
I'll get this. But I want to know from you, Betty, your opinion, if you think some of these are petty or pretty reasonable.
Okay.
So the first one was if someone is like the youngest sibling, they think that's like an ick that somebody is the youngest sibling.
I guess because it carries a stereotype that they get their way all the time, that they're a baby. I wouldn't say no, but I would definitely have to dig into that. Just like they
you'd
would
watch
with,
the behaviors.
Yeah, like they would with me once they found out I was an only child. Like they would be like,
yeah, like an only child and a youngest sibling. Does that even work?
Yeah,
I'm real curious.
Sure. Yeah. This next one, someone said, I won't date somebody who has a peanut allergy because I love peanut butter.
Oh, absolutely.
So much.
I get that when it comes to like if he has a cat allergy.
Yeah.
Like I love my cats.
Yeah,
sure.
I get that.
I don't know.
That's fair. And you don't want to be carrying an EpiPen everywhere you go.
Oh,
well,
no.
I understand that.
Yeah.
Again, this last one I think might have the most relevance to you. It says, someone said, I won't date someone who likes reality TV. And I know that you're more into like the crime reality TV,
yes,
but like I know you've enjoyed reality TV. Like, do you think that somebody...
I will say, like, if someone knows the characters of a reality TV show, knows their past, knows their... Don't be because you're right there, Wally.
I know, 90
like,
Day Fiancé.
90 Day
like
Fiancé.
They're your friend.
Wally couldn't tell you the person that he had met that morning, but he could tell you every character from every season of 90 Day Fiancé.
Paul and Carini, season 2. Crazy.
That does give the ick factor.
This is why you're married. Like, it's good that you're married and not getting back out into the world.
Now, you don't like reality TV per se, but you loved like Dateline. So would you ever date anyone that was featured on Dateline?
Oh, like a star?
No, like just a person that was on there. Yes.
Like a witness or?
Not so much witness. I'm just seeing where we're at right now on your dating barometer.
No.
Okay, maybe. Uplift thing, Way FM. This is the Wally Show, and Betty Rock wanted to do this thing where we take the last text that we sent or received and talk about what was going on with that, because it started from a conversation we were having in the office where I got a text that said, yes, talk to you then. And I'm like, oh, no, this is bad. Yeah, this is really bad.
You're kind of anxious when it comes to text messages and you really read into it.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Well, this was from our consultant. Again, this is a guy I've known for 31 years, but he works with our show and critiques us and gives us things to work on and stuff. And I was like, hey, we're going to have our other boss join us, you know, so just give you a heads up. And when he sent back, yes, talk to you then, I read it as, yes, talk to you then, which in my head is, busted. I'm going to tell Betty and Gavin how great they are, and every problem in the show is going to be you, and it's going to happen in front of your other boss now. And so, hold
good
on.
Time.
Buckle up, Buttercup. It's going to be a ride. Meetings. Yeah, you love them. They're great.
You read a lot into that.
I did, all from, yes, talk to you then, because there was no emoji, there was no smiley face. There's like, hey, this will be a short one. Mm-hmm. It's not a big deal. It'll be fun. But yes, talk to you then. And this happens tomorrow, and I have so much trepidation about it.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I'm going to call him and tell him to lamb blast you. let's go with Gavin next. What was your last text?
Okay, so this was a video that my wife sent me, but I wanted to play the audio for you guys.
That's a baby heartbeat.
Are you having a baby? Oh, my gosh, Gavin, that's amazing. Thank you for breaking that news here.
We are having a kid.
No, you're not.
No, you're
we
not.
Are having a kid.
Oh, I was kidding.
No, that is a heartbeat of my 13-week-old child.
No! What? This is me thinking that you're still lying to me.
I am not. Wait, you want me to pull up the ultrasound?
Wait. What?
I'm freaking shaking right now.
Wait, how did you?
Wait.
Well, don't ask how. Like, Betty's trying to figure out
how. No, okay, let's how see have here. You been so calm around us with yeah. this going
it's been
on?
The hardest thing
what in the
my
world?
Life for 13 weeks, 3 months.
That is crazy. Well, congratulations, dude. I had no idea. I mean, I literally was making a joke thinking you were kidding. It was somebody else as a friend or something like that. That is insane. Betty's just shocked.
I feel like I lost out on 13 weeks.
Yeah.
Well, now you get
another. Well, no one tells like the first 12 weeks or so. Like, and it's weird because it feels like you're our child, Gavin. And like,
how can you, a child have a child?
I know. I don't know how this is happening.
So, like, are you guys grandparents now?
Yeah, I guess so. This is great. Call me Papaw. Oh, my goodness.
Well, I can't follow that.
Well, I know.
Yeah,
we're
going to hold on to yours,
Rock. I was hoping
Rock.
Mine would be last.
Yeah, we're going to hold on to yours because that was pretty great, actually.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, congratulations, Gavin. Nicely done.
Wow. Gavin's going to be a dad. That's weird.
Let that sink in for a minute.
Uplifting Way FM.
You've heard of history. Well, this is Herstory with Betty Rock.
History was made at the 2024 Miss America pageant thanks to Miss Colorado Madison Marsh. Doesn't Madison Marsh just sound like a pageant name?
It does. It really does.
It really does. Well, Marsh was crowned Miss America, making her the first active duty military service member to win the title in the event's nearly 100-year history.
Oh, that's really cool. I love that.
At only 22, Marsh is a second lieutenant in the Air Force and recently became a graduate of the Air Force Academy, earning a degree in physics and a focus on astronomy.
Oh, wow. Good for her.
So she's super smart. And when asked what her hopes are for carrying the title of Miss America, she stated she wanted to show younger girls all around the world that you can achieve anything and that the only person that's stopping you is you.
I think what I like about this, because I'm a girl dad, you know, and I think what I like about this is the pageant world, you tend to think of them all as Barbies and and almost like empty vases. Mm-hmm. You know, that's a stereotype, I realize. Mm-hmm. But you take somebody that is like very accomplished like this and active duty military, which would be a stereotype that you would think, oh, how does that fit in with a beauty pageant kind of thing? But she does. She's proof that you can be anything. You can be all things.
Exactly. She said she also wanted to thank the Air Force for their training her and sharpening her leadership skills. And I think that's a good testimony to have as well, because I think there are some people who are younger who are kind of lost and don't know what to do with their lives. And she joined the Air Force, and maybe the military is something that you want to consider, but you're thinking, well, what's in it for me? There's a lot of things that go into it. Not only are you helping yourself, but you're helping others too.
Plus, they probably did wonders for her posture. Like they make you stand at a straight at attention, and that's a really big thing in pageants.
Yep.
I could use a little military time to fix this hump on my back.
Random acts of audio.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and today's random act of audio comes to us courtesy of scrolling through TikTok. I found this video and I thought it was really cool, and I've found songs on TikTok before that I like ended up really liking, like Fancy Like by Walker Hayes.
Yeah, we fancy like Applebee's on a date night.
There's so many songs I've never heard the whole song. Like, you just hear the little clip on TikTok. Oh, I really like that. And so that was kind of cool for this one. It caught my eye. So I stopped when this guy, Forrest Frank, was talking to his friend as he's a musician guy. And so he's playing like these chord progressions. And he asks his friend some questions, you know, so that he could write a song on the spot. And this is kind of how it went down.
Bro, what do these chords make you think of?
Good day.
Good day? I see that. What are three words that have to do with a good day to you?
Sun.
Sun.
Birds.
Birds, I hear that.
God.
God. Love it. Let's see what I can do. Hey, I'm about to have a good day. No matter what they say. Sun is shining down on me. Birds are singing praise. I'm about to have a good day in every single way. The God who made the universe knows me by my name, so it's a good day.
And it was funny because it was fun to watch his friend kind of like, okay, he's riffing a little bit and birds singing praise, whatever. Then he gets to the God who made the universe, knows me by my name. His friend just sits up forward as like feeling the vibe of it. Like, man, this is good. This is a bop, man, as the kids would say. And so like, I don't know this kid. Like, so I looked up his profile and it was a bunch of Christian stuff and songs that he's been working on. And so in a place like TikTok that can be a real cesspool, it was nice to see some light in the, you know, midst of some of that darkness.
God who made the universe knows me by my name, so it's a good day.
So I gave it a like. What are you gonna do? You know? Thumb up it.
What was the guy's name?
A Forrest Frank. Like Forrest. Run Forrest Run.
That's
Forrest
cool.
Frank.
Run Forrest.
Yeah, that's how you can remember it. But anyway, just kind of a cool thing, and that's your random act of audio for today. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and Gavin loves sports, but we don't want to get into facts and figures. Betty Rock and I are more, you know, pedestrian sports fans, and so we want to find other things in the sports world that are, like, applicable to more people's lives than just sports guys. So that's why we came up with Yay Sports. So, Gavin, you get to talk about sports.
I do, and I'll start with, you know, in-game stuff, but it's going to lead to a different place, I promise. So, Buffalo Bills, they recently played the Kansas City Chiefs in an NFL playoff game, and it was one of those down-to-the-wire games. It was very exciting, and in the end, the score was 27-24, and a Buffalo Bills kicker, his name is Tyler Bass, was up to kick a field goal to tie the game. Kicks the ball. It goes wide right. He misses. The Bills are a tortured fan base, so their reaction to this miss, obviously you would think they'd be upset by that.
Oh, yeah. I watched a guy crying in the stands because he had gotten a tattoo that said Super Bowl champions. He was convinced that they were going all the way, and they weren't even in the finals yet.
Yeah, but it sounds like he has other life choices that he needs to look into.
Oh, yeah. It was so funny, though.
Such a bummer. But unfortunately, so Tyler Bass, he misses the field goal, and after he misses the field goal, again, fans get crazy. Apparently, he was getting like death threats.
That's insane.
After the game.
Me.
Again, I love sports. I invest a lot of my like time and energy and spirit into them. But if my team loses, I'm bummed. I can back away from it. So people reacted poorly in this scenario, but apparently they bounced back after making death threats.
Okay, we all make bad mistakes. I was a little wrong there with the death threat. Let me walk that back a minute.
And they are instead, you know, 1 or 2 days afterwards, they started donating thousands of dollars in the name of a no-kill animal shelter that he is a big fan of and is really invested in. And so people were calling or were calling in and donating $22 because his number is two. So they were trying to up the ante. And in like 2 days after death threats, they actually raised $100,000 for this no-kill animal shelter. So
that's awesome.
Obviously, it's a bummer for the Buffalo Bills.
Yeah,
but you know, if you know he doesn't miss the field goal, then maybe the animal shelter doesn't get $100,000.
It doesn't, and so really, there was some good news that came out of that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I had heard Betty talk about this story too, and she pointed out like a huge irony in that The no-kill animal shelter benefited from death threats to this guy.
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
Let's not give towards something that helps with human life, instead with animal life. But I mean, I am thankful. It's just funny.
It was just weird. Yeah, it's just ironic. Just
very much so.
There you go. That's Jay Sports.
Growing up in poverty has never been easy for children, but with the added challenges of the pandemic, conflict, and natural disasters, families around the world are facing an unprecedented food crisis. Unfortunately, those who are already hungry are now even more desperate. But by sponsoring a child through Compassion, you can help provide life-sustaining essentials such as food and clean water. And with your compassionate support, that child can not only survive, but also flourish. You can find out how and choose a child to sponsor when you click on the Compassion banner at wayfm.com.
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Rock Report with Betty Rock.
If you're one of those people who are just sick of hearing all about the relationship between Taylor Swift and Kansas City Chiefs player Travis Kelce, I get it. I am with you. I'm right there with you. But this is just too cute not to talk about. The Chiefs play the Ravens this weekend in Baltimore, and locals are assuming that Taylor will be there to cheer on her honey bunny. So, one Baltimore assisted living facility, they decided to post a TikTok asking their residents where they suggested Taylor should go while she's in town. And here's what they had to suggest.
You must go to the aquarium. It's wonderful.
Grab a bite to eat at Jimmy Seafood's crab cake.
If you arrive early on Sunday, stop at the Shirley's for breakfast.
Oh, that's so great. That's so, and they have no idea that Taylor Swift could buy all those places they just mentioned, even the aquarium.
They're probably like, who's Taylor Swift? I don't even know.
Oh, that's adorable.
But I think it's precious, and I hope that Taylor Swift sees it, because at the end of the video, the director of the facility was like, Taylor, you should come and visit us, and I think that would be so cute.
Yeah, I think that would be cool, because Taylor's really good about fan stuff, and I know it can be calculated, and some of it can seem that way, like you're just doing it for the press or whatever, but she doesn't need any press. But if she showed up and then took these people to one of those places, did an outing to the aquarium or going to Shirley's, I hear they got great pot pie. That would be
crab cakes.
That would be the home run for this segment.
I might even become a fan after that.
Oh, wow. That would be amazing. That's a miracle right there. All right, that's going to do it for your Rock Report. Thank you, Lady Rock.
And now for some good news.
Uplifting Way FM, this here is the Wally Show. We're going to do a little good news giddy up, a roundup, a cavalcade of some good news stories, because the regular news can be a bit of a bummer. We're going to kick things off with you, Gavin. What you got?
A summer camp in Texas called Slumber Falls was about to be sold and turned into something else. So a bunch of former campers launched a GoFundMe, pulled their money, and bought it themselves to keep it going.
Oh my gosh, that is fantastic.
That's interesting.
I love when adults like form kickball leagues and things like that from their childhood, and so saving their camp. And then when you're like an adult, you're like, why did we save this? When you go back, you're like, I'm getting chiggers and fleas here. Why did we save this? But I love that. This was kind of cool. There's a woman in New York, and she just got to meet two of the police officers who pulled her from a burning car when she was a kid. This happened like back in 1968, and both of the men are retired now. But what was really cool is when she meets them, she got to tell them that she now is a cop as well.
Aww.
And so, and so she's like, I wanted to do what they did for me for others. And
awesome.
So that definitely made them feel good. Like, oh man, what I did really did matter in my life. Betty Rock, good news, giddy up, go.
There was a Wisconsin...
Wisconsin.
I got you.
Couple, thank you, that they realized that they were in labor, active labor. So they get in the car and they're like, we got to run to the hospital. We got to go now. But there was a snowstorm that was upon them. So they realize, okay, we can't make it to the hospital. We're actually going to pull over into a McDonald's parking lot.
That's God's provision right there, because you're like, look, I don't know how this baby thing's going to play out, but I could really use a Big Mac.
So they pull over in the parking lot and they call 911. Ambulance gets there and they realize, okay, the baby's coming now.
Oh, wow.
So we can't make it. Okay, so she starts going into labor, pushes out the baby. The baby is good, healthy, fine. Here's what's so funny, though. They already had a name picked out for the baby before they even knew this was all going to go down. His name was going to be called Micah Daniel.
Okay.
Well, people started realizing, if you shorten that, it could be Mickey D.
Oh.
Or McDonald's.
That's pretty great. Oh. If my wife had given birth at McDonald's, I would have been so happy.
You're like, dinner's on me, everyone.
That's right. McRibs for everyone. Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show, and we are doing Snap Judgment right now. This is where Betty Rock takes a couple songs that are up for consideration here on Way FM from our music guy, and we get your opinion on it. We play a little snippet of it or a snap. We see what our thoughts are, our first impressions. Then we play the hook, see if it changes any. But you get to decide ultimately which song you want to hear a little bit more of here on Way FM today. So, with that said, Lady Rock, what is song number one?
This first one is called God is Good.
Very simple. God is good.
Yeah. Simple right. Message.
Here we go. Here's the snap.
I trust the plans he has for me.
What?
No matter what my eyes can see.
Ooh, what in the world was that?
It was like a lot to take in.
It was. I did not see it going there, but then my foot started tapping and I felt happy.
To me, I'm out, though, because it sounds like he's behind, like, a little Casio or a Play School type
keyboard.
And he's like,
Okay, all right. I kind of want to see where it goes. I actually liked it. The first note, I was like, wait, what? And then I leaned into it because I'm mature when it comes to my taste in music. So I'm going to go in, Gavin.
I'm in the same ballpark it caught off by surprise,
yeah,
but in a fun way.
Okay, well, let's hear the hooksy and see if our opinions change at all.
God is good, yes he is. Through it all, I'm sure of this. I'm safe inside my father's hands. I'll sing it again. Yeah, God is good.
Oh, there we go. I gotta go out. Gotta go out, man.
You don't like the...
It's late to the party for me on the choir thing. Like, the choir thing we've been doing for a lot of years now, and it gets big, and I get it. And here we go. We've all got robes on, and I'm sorry. I'm out.
I am actually in.
Really?
Interesting.
Because I feel like it's an easy song to sing along to.
Yeah, that's true.
And it's got a great message.
I'm sure it'll grow on me a little bit, but I got to go out. And when I start hearing everyone still doing choirs, it dates it for me.
I didn't personally hear enough of a twist lyrically.
Right.
Like, I was hoping for a more unique twist on some of those phrases, but they're phrases that I think are...
Again, like, out here, when I'm just chopping wood, God is good. You know, you didn't see that coming. You know,
I did not see that coming.
Yeah, exactly, and that's what makes a great song. So I'll help wood chop it with him or workshop it with him in the future. So Gavin out. Yeah. All right, Betty, the only one in. But her opinion was changed. All right, so maybe you had the same reaction. I don't know. That's song number one. File that one away, because we've still got song number two to come up, and then you're going to decide which song you like best. So we'll do that in 10 here on The Wally Show. Lady Rock, what is the name that you have picked for song number two?
This one is simply called He Does.
He Does.
Not that he doesn't, or but he does. But he does.
It's very it's very positive.
That's right.
Yeah. He might isn't very positive.
No, he might could.
Yeah, it's country.
But he did.
Yeah, here we go. He does.
He sees us. There ain't no one love me like Jesus.
Oh, Jesus and Jesus. Sign me up for that rhyme scheme. Jesus is very hard to rhyme with.
You're right.
Yeah, yeah. And he sees us, Jesus. Cheese us, you know, like
cheeses.
So, yeah. So that's not easy to do. I don't even know who this is, but good on them. I'm in. Betty Rock.
Simply by rhyming Jesus with seasons.
It's all I needed. It's all I needed. It's when Casting Crowns first rhymed people with steeple, did it twice on the same album. I was in both times.
Well, the bar you set so low to be astounded with. Okay. I'm going out. It was very slow for me. It was it was a bit on the side.
Okay.
So, but maybe it'll go somewhere.
Who knows? Yeah. Gavin?
I can't get over rhyming Jesus. And I thought it sounded good, too. I thought that it was somewhere. Yeah, I want to see where we're going.
Had a cool vibe. All right. Yeah. Well, here we go. This is the hook for He Does. That's interesting. I feel like I'm on a Christian cruise. It has kind of, it's weird. It has like a little bit of
like
an island vibe in there. It feels pretty good. It's a little early in the season for that. This is a summer song to me. So I think I'm gonna go out. I'm gonna change from the Jesus. It wasn't enough to hold me. The Jesus sees this rhyme wasn't enough to hold me, apparently.
I feel like we are just trading back and forth because now I'm
in. Now you're in?
Yeah.
You're just being contrarian.
I guess I am.
You
should have
said,
no,
I'm not.
Oh, wait. Now I'm confused. I just think it had a good positive like summer vibe, and I think we could all use that.
What's really funny is you were out on the first song and then in, out on the second song and then in. That was your pattern today. Gavin?
I'm 100% in on that.
Okay,
so Gavin's in. I had a fun time, and that's all I care about.
Gavin was in on both of those, so I was the only one that went out. So, all right, here we go. This is your job. You need to tell us which of these two songs you like and why. You've heard our reasons, but they don't matter. Which one do you want to hear more of on Way FM? So here is the first song. It is God Is Good.
God is good, yes he is. Through it all, I'm sure of this. I'm safe inside my
And song number two, He Does. So there you go. Those are your two choices now. 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. All you have to do is tell us which song you like better and why, and you can make the decision today. Debbie, thank you so much for joining us. Now, you've heard the hooks of the two songs up for consideration here on Snap Judgment, and now you get to make the decision as to which of these songs you want to hear more of on Way FM and why. So, what are you going to do? Song number one or song number two?
Song number two, Jesus Sees Us, Please Us.
Okay, see, yeah, Jesus Sees Us. That was what I liked about the snap, because he rhymed that. And then, full disclosure, I was out on the hook. Betty Rock and Gavin both in on this song, and just like you. So why'd you like it?
I like the tune. I like the beat. I just liked it.
Do you have any guesses as to who sang it?
No. I'm kind of new to Way FM.
Oh, okay. Well, welcome. And that would be the one and only Brandon Heath.
That surprises me. Like, it didn't sound like Brandon Heath to me, honestly. Did you think it sounded like Brandon
Heath? Oh, yeah, for sure.
It did?
Yeah. And the song you passed up on, Debbie, God Is Good, that one was by Austin French.
That one sounded like Austin French.
And that's a good song, too.
It's not like there's a bad song. It's like, okay, which one do you want to hear more of? Which one connects with you more? Because we can't play every song, you know? And so Debbie likes it. It is song number two. He Does. Thank you so much, Debbie, for helping us out today with a little snap judgment. It's Brandon Heath on Way FM.
Okay, thank you.
Wouldn't it be great if there was an answer? A quench for the heart, a cure for cancer. Holding us close like a tiny dancer.
Well, that's the end, but it doesn't have to be. Check out our Aftercast. It's new stuff you didn't hear in the podcast. Be sure to rate us on iTunes as well as connect with us on social media. Just search Wally Show. And if you'd like to join our Facebook group made exclusively for you potties, the link is in the description of this podcast. Thanks to Colorado Christian University Online for supporting what we do.